Hello, YouTubers. This is the noobifier. I'm really close to retirement. My army gear is turned in, meaning I don't even have a uniform anymore. There's some little bits of admin left, but it feels very good, and I'm super excited. This time each year, CIG does do a total shutdown for Christmas, and then it takes a couple weeks before everything gets back to normal. This lull is normally when I take time to clean up, prepare a bunch for the coming new year. In actuality, this year has been even busier than standard. There's a new playlist called Community Concerns, and that takes about a day to research each week. And your feedback so far has been very positive, despite a lower than expected view count. So please help me reach a wider audience with that playlist by letting people know that it exists. The real point today, though, is to highlight the classic story of having a problem and then fixing it properly. No hacks or band-aid solutions. Let's hit it exactly with the right tool, like using a scalpel to do surgery instead of a sledgehammer. With the help of Monster Tech in the next few weeks, we will have the most insane set of simulation rigs in this space, purpose-built for live streaming, flight, and road sim. The way I plan to configure the two MTS sim pits will require a large space, which has been prepared over the last month, but a space that large also comes with a compromise. If you'd seen the brick in the wall video, the aesthetics of the space have been dialed to 11. Bricks are very pretty, but microphones don't like them too much because they're big flat surfaces. When trying to record sounds, ideally what you'd want is to capture the source and avoid pollution. Pollution can be other sounds, people speaking in a different room, and the pollution can also be the skip back of the original source. Once it's part of the recorded track, it's almost impossible to remove or correct for it. For the eSport team, we had tested this space for interviews, where two people had two microphones but faced to one camera. During that test day, I learned so much and identified some things that should be corrected next time. When doing this sort of two-person podcast in the future, two people will face each other. There will be three cameras, one for each person's face and a wider shot. Both microphones need to be the same type, so I'm going to have to pick up a second SM7B. The two people need to stay much closer to the microphone. I should add a third microphone that would be used as a backup in case something goes wrong. By doing this, the two people can make eye contact and remain in line with the microphones, resulting in a more natural conversation and, most importantly, proper audio. This will really help bring up the quality, but the echo may still be apparent. Very apparent, actually, compared to the treated room that I normally use. I plan to do live streaming from this room as often as 4 times per week every week, and I wanted to do something about this. Phase one was to look at what Arrowzoom had to offer and what would make the most sense. I've used their products throughout my recording booth to improve the performance on the double doors, and now I would find something to control the audio in the new large open studio space. Ideally, what I want is isolation and anechoic. Isolation is preventing unwanted external noises from registering on your audio track. This is actually very difficult to do in the new space because it's so large. You can help by choosing a microphone that rejects well, such as a shotgun directional or some sort of cardioid. I know that the SM7B has better rejection, so if you turn the gain down a little bit and get a little bit closer, you can achieve a little bit of fake isolation. But isolation, true isolation, needs layers of like what I have in the recording studio. But this won't be possible in the new location, so I'm just going to rely on the right mic, and I may consider playing with what's called a noise gate, but I would prefer to not use it. Along with isolation, I wanted to tackle anechoic, or free of echo. This is done with your baffles, traps, blankets, curtains, foam, felt pads, and carpets. Simply, the more stuff you have in the room results in a reduced chance that the source is going to pass by the microphone, hit something flat, and then return and reverberate. Not only more stuff, but the type of surface. And I wanted to add something that would also blend in and look nice in this new room. I wanted to stay away from the standard pyramid foam. That wall surface is part of the VR section of the studio, and I had fear that a rogue VR controller might hit it and tear it. Plus, that type of foam doesn't really work well with the aesthetic that I wanted. And that new peel and stick hex panel was exactly what I was looking for. I measured the wall, and then by using their tile calculator, decided upon how many tiles I would need. I placed the order with a mixture of gray, white, and then a smaller order of black. You can do whatever combinations you want, like pink, orange, red, or more. However, I was trying to blend with the mostly monochromatic theme in that room. Once in the cart, I used my own code, which is AZ1337, and I checked out with a 10% discount. In 10 minutes, I had order confirmation, and in 12 hours, I had tracking. 6 days later, I received the bundles and carefully opened the parcels, and then I let the panels sit overnight to fully puff out a little bit. That night, I actually couldn't resist the opportunity to play around with the design by testing layouts on the floor. I got to move everything around without having to commit or making a mistake. I snapped a picture for reference and then went to bed. The next morning, I made a final measurement from top to bottom and left to right. I chose a low middle start point that would distribute the tiles equally all around, then using a laser as my guide, I placed the first row. That sounds simple, and it was. The peel and stick is super satisfying and easy. The glue holds instantly with some pressure, but if you mess up, you can actually pull and reset. The glue will also wash out with a wet rag, which is pretty neat if you're renting where you live. Tile after tile, the project went very quickly with fantastic results. I was happy to hear that the room started to feel a little bit more full. There was less echo than before. It did make a progressive difference as more and more were added. In a world where we're working from home on voice calls, in a world where we're spending more and more time inside, I can honestly say that there are more real-world uses for this type of product that have nothing to do with being a content creator. Obviously, in this specific case, I knew that we would all benefit from better audio on my livestream content. My results are good so far, and I plan to add more strategically in the room to help out even more. It was never my plan to make this space a recording booth. I knew going in to manage my own expectations because the space is so large with flat surfaces, and I feel I can do even more with a couple more tiles. It sounds much better now even though it's empty, and as we add more and more items such as carpet and sim rigs, the audio will get even better. So I'll leave you with some final thoughts. Is it the most cost effective? You can find DIY projects on the internet that may turn out to be cheaper, but I think by the time you get everything together, it'll work out to be the same. Fast shipping. Yes, I didn't expect it in less than a week. Peel and stick with no risk of damaging the wall, and as I said, the room is now better controlled. This would be even more effective in a smaller room, but as I said, I'm sure that if I keep adding tiles to the wall, the performance will improve even more. So in closing, I wanted to thank Arrowzoom for providing the community a promo code and taking all the BS and guesswork out of the process of achieving better audio. Conference calls, being able to just sit and relax, making a bedroom quiet for a baby, or even your own sanity. I have all the links you'll ever need, plus a promo code, plus a room calculator in the description. Search the net for other people's designs, and please stay tuned for more as I continue to evolve the channel. Thank you very much for spending your time with me. If you liked the video and got something out of it, please share. Fly safe, and I'll see you in the verse.
Hello, YouTubers. This is the noobifier. Welcome to Echo. This is the new part of the studio where the live streaming is going to be, and with this, you can probably hear that this room does not sound anything like the other treated room, the studio, and that's because it has all kinds of reflective walls, and none of it has been specifically designed or treated to correct this. So hopefully you can understand that no matter what you do, you really can't get away from this. However, you can fix certain things in post. You can add echo delays and all kinds of other stuff. However, the best way to treat the room is to treat the room. And that is combating the echo, reducing the amount of skip that you can get off of surfaces. Basically, what you want is the sound to leave a source and then get absorbed. The reduction is very specific if I'm speaking in the direction of the wall, which is good. There are still a lot of things missing from this room, such as a carpet. There's no sim rigs or anything like that in here as well. So I'm expecting the overall effect to improve even more. I do notice that there's a capacity to put more on the sides, maybe another row on the sides and one on the top. The reality is I think that that would be a diminishing return. But like I said, once we get some 65-inch TVs attached to some sim rigs in here, some carpet on the floor, and a little bit more proximity to the microphone, I think it's going to improve greatly. And a special thank you to Arrowzoom because everything was pre-installed. You just had to peel and stick. Once the center point was found and the overall measurements were calculated and marked off, laser set, and then you just go from there.